and unity we must have to start now. Because, I mean, how long would we have to suffer? We'll just learn these things that we must be united.
That's right.
Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Holy Day of Atonement. This is actually Heroes Day today, Monday, October 20th. Man, it was like a family reunion, a righteous family reunion. So if you didn't make it, we're here for you and we love you. It's the Nation of Islam.
Where you at, brother?
I'm in Kingston, Ma.
What?
Kingston.
Tell the people about the surroundings here. Tell them about the people, the vibe, everything.
The fruit is energized by the sun, so it's healthy. The people are energized by the sun, so they're loving. Yes. Even though you'll be in the most impoverished part of a city, it's still the most warmest people you've ever met. So, you know, these are people of God. The Honorable Mr. Louis Farrakhan is a general. So a general leads men into war, but we know our weapons are not physical. Our weapon is the truth. So we came out in the hundreds and by the thousands to greet our people, and they loved it. So, man, I'm energized by the energy of the people, energized by the message from the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, and just energized by the love from the believers. So,
now you came in Tuesday. Tell me some of the activities that you got involved with.
Highs and more highs. A pleasure moment, but blessed to travel with Brother Nuri. So we went to a prison, and this was the worst place I've been to in my life, without a shadow of a doubt. And at this prison, you know, you have black men that are washing themselves out of a bucket. You have guards that have AK-47s. But after that hour lecture by Brother Nuri, the wardsman of the prison said he loved and enjoyed the message. So it's been a blessing. I believe that was Wednesday. We went out in mass in the community, passed out thousands of flyers, touched people's hands, and, you know, showed some love. Yeah, so there's so much, but those are just a few things that came to mind. Yeah, it's a beautiful weekend.
Yes, beautiful, bro.
Oh, we also went to a school, Haile Selassie High School. Brother Nuri spoke there, and it was beautiful. You know, you saw, even in the hottest weather, they still had their uniforms on, remained disciplined. And even after his short talk with the students, the one question that they had is that they wanted to hear more. So this is an invincible truth that we have. We just have to stand on it, man, and go to our people and show them love.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Brother Hassan, Watson number 18, Cleveland, Ohio, here in Jamaica. About to head on the plane. Had an excellent weekend. And it's good to meet my brother, Brother Omar. Yes.
Assalamu alaikum, family. My name is Brother Wayne Muhammad from London, England, Mosque number one in the UK, under the leadership of Brother Student Minister Hilary Muhammad. I've had a beautiful time here, coming to support with the Muhammad family, our leader, teacher, and God, the Most Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, as he galvanizes the Caribbean to move forward and take our people to the next level. It's been absolutely awesome, and now the work really starts, and we need to move forward from this day on.
Right.
Assalamu alaikum.
Well, first of all, I'm Brother Anthony Muhammad from Chicago via New York. But I've absolutely enjoyed myself here. Being here with the man of God is extremely exciting. I'm just so pleased that Allah would see fit to have introduced me to this wonderful Nation of Islam, that I can be with our leader, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, not just here in Jamaica enjoying myself as a tourist, but here as a representative of him and a supporter of him, and by Allah's grace, perhaps a protector of him.
From women in support of the Million Man March in the beautiful city of Newark, New Jersey. I give greetings to certainly the minister and all of the believers here at Savings Day in Kingston, Jamaica. How profound the minister bringing us to Kingston, Jamaica this year for the 19th anniversary of the Million Man March. I thank Allah so very much for Minister Louis Farrakhan, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, who have nurtured and assisted us in teaching children for over 20 years in the city of Newark. And this has been just an absolutely wonderful experience, beloved, since that. We've been to Jamaica many times, but never in Kingston. You know, and there was a reason that we never were in Kingston. And so we visited Bob Marley, we visited Marcus Garvey, we visited the heroes and the Revolutionary Park, Emancipation Park. How absolutely splendid. So we thank Allah much, and on behalf of the women in support of the Million Man March, who I am so proud to be a part of, who came from the Million Man March, inspired over 50,000 men to go to Washington, D.C. in 1995, and then came back and took education, you know, and I mean, everyone knows. It's been a wonderful journey, and we're still working towards doing Allah's will. I thank you so much.
Anniversarymof the MMM. I have been a servant to the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, when I say servant, a believer, for the past 35 years or more. I was very honored to meet the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan at Warren AME Church in Los Angeles, California in 1983. And he asked me to come to Chicago in 1985 to help coordinate the first International Savings Day that we had with the late Colonel Gaddafi via satellite. And I've been very blessed to work with him over the years. He appointed me as the National Chief of Protocol for the Nation of Islam, and also the National Director of Community Outreach for Personal Liaison. And then when he decided that he was going to, when Allah put it on his heart and mind to have the Million Man March, to call a million men to Washington, D.C. in 1995, he appointed me as the National Deputy Director. And I worked directly under Minister Ben Chambers, who was the National Director. And that was a wonderful experience. And what was really so beautiful about it, I was able to see my granddaughter at the age of 10 to recite the poem by Dr. Maya Angelou. And all these years, I've been able to work with the minister, his family, and my fellow colleagues on the National Executive Board. And now I am the National Director of Fundraising for the Nation of Islam. And at 76, I'm very happy. I've written the book, Memories. I was inspired to write the book by the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, Reverend Tricia Jackson Sr., Dr. Kathy Hughes, the late Dr. Maya Angelou, and the late Dr. Dorothy Hite of the National Council of Negro Women all wrote the reviews for my book. So I am a very, very happy.
From Charlotte, North Carolina, my mama's number 36.
How'd you enjoy your weekend in Kingston?
Sir, as of yet, it is indescribable. I am still processing all that I was able to experience and am experiencing, so it'll be some time before I fully understand the total weight and impact of what I had an opportunity to experience.
My daughter, Sister Sadera, Haru Muhammad Sadera.
Assalamu alaikum. And what did you think about what the minister had to say yesterday?
Oh, it's awesome. It's awesome. Well-needed time. I mean, words can't really describe what he brought to the island, to the whole family. Yeah.
Jamaica is special. We know that. And the plan that the minister mentioned about the unity with the Rasta community, how are we going to implement some of that work?
How are we going to implement what he wants?
Yes.
The unity?
Yes.
Well, I think he said it all yesterday. Yes. How are we going to do it? You know, we got to unite on the common ground.
Yes. Yes.
It's only one faith, one Lord. You know, just like Marcus Garvey, the great words from Marcus Garvey. We realize that if we want people, and the unity will be easy.
That's right. And young sister, how about you? How did you like being in Kingston? Good. What did you do? Some of the things that you did while you was here. Took a tour? Where'd you go?
Devin's Bakery.
Oh, wow. Oh, nice. That's an ice cream place, right? Yes. And did you go to the park, Emancipation Park? No? Oh, you gotta go see that. It's nice. It's right next door. But you like it in Jamaica? Yes. All right, bro.
Thank you, bro.
Brother John Muhammad, Asbury Park, New Jersey.
And tell us about the experience in Kingston.
Oh, brother, very historic to be here with the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan and the believers, the spirit of Jamaica. It's a wonderful spirit to be out in the streets with the MGT, with the Flyers. I'll never forget. The Warriors here in Kingston, this is where I wanted to be. Not Montego Bay, not Ocho Rios, but the heart of Jamaica was right here. We felt that this weekend. And what the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan said yesterday will echo and reverberate around the whole Caribbean, brother. So it's a paradigm shift right now. I'm honored to be here.
Brother Delvin Muhammad out of Durham, North Carolina. I think that this weekend was a great weekend. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan came and he did what he wanted to do. He wanted to wake up the Caribbean, the home of his father, and he wanted the people to know that there's a better way of doing things. And in order to do that, I mean, the people have the heart, they have the spirit, because they have already shown to the world and to black people all over the continent their heart by the degree of leadership that had come from this great island. And I'm just so honored to be here and to be a part of the delegation of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan and the Nation of Islam. Thank you so very much. Yes, sir.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Akbar Muhammad, and I was blessed to be here in Jamaica with the minister. I was blessed to come here with him in 1971, 43 years ago. And the program that my brother just explained to me that you're doing for young people is a great program, and there has to be a level of consistency. It has to continue to move. The thing about it is that the minister came here and made a tremendous impact on not only Jamaica, but the whole country. And I hope and pray to Allah that you will continue to do it and that the Muslims who come here will know about your program, and it should be published in the Final Call and advertised in America, because this is an opportunity of a lifetime to spread the words and the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad as given to our people by Minister Louis Farrakhan. Thank you very much.
And unity with the must have to start now. Because, I mean, how long would we have to suffer? We'll just learn these things that we must be united.
That's right. Truly, we're involved in a struggle. So what we gonna do? We gotta make it right for our people. For our forefathers and mothers. That's right.
We must be united.
For the seeds.
We must be united. We must be united.
Spiritual warriors.
Woman, old